And I think with the new president, you're going to see much more honesty in the Ukraine. And that's what we're looking for. We're supporting a country. We want to make sure that country is honest. It's very important to talk about corruption. If you don't talk about corruption, why would you give money to a country that you think is corrupt? One of the reasons the new president got elected is he was going to stop corruption. So it's very important that on occasion you speak to somebody about corruption. Very important.
This is Trump at the UN General Assembly admitting once again that he asked Ukraine's president to investigate Joe Biden in what is all but certain to be the condition for releasing $250 million in military aid to them. Right off the bat, where do you even begin with the hypocrisy of Trump grandstanding about corruption when the method he used to try and root it out was likely the single most corrupt act he's committed as president? He took taxpayer-funded military aid, withheld it until he had a phone call with Ukraine's new president, demanded 8 separate times on that call that they open an investigation to his top political opponent, and only then released the money along with $140 million more than they expected. And then when a curiously timed whistleblower complaint came out just 2.5 weeks after his phone call involving communications with a foreign leader and a promise that Trump made, a complaint that Trump's own appointed intelligence community inspector general agreed did in fact meet the statutory definition of a serious and urgent concern, Trump's director of national intelligence buried it, claiming that it didn't meet the criteria so that Congress wouldn't have access to it, despite it being against the law to withhold the complaint. And amid all of this, Trump is pretending that he's concerned about corruption? I mean, even Eric Trump could see through that one. Here's the thing, Trump knows what he did was illegal, but A, he doesn't think anyone will do anything about it, and so far he's been right, given the fact that we know of 10 instances of obstruction of justice from the Mueller investigation, and Democrats still haven't managed to hold him to account for any of it. I mean, his call to the Ukrainian president came one day after Mueller testified in front of Congress. He knew that if Democrats couldn't manage to mobilize for impeachment after the guy leading the investigation literally came in front of the nation and said, clear as day, that Trump was not exonerated, that he was basically free to just go ahead and do it again. And so now, that's exactly where we are. And B, he's trying to give the impression that what he did was justified because it was the means to some noble end to nab Biden on corruption. But even if Biden did something wrong, for which there is absolutely zero evidence, that doesn't absolve Trump of conspiring with a foreign power, of what seems to be a $140 million bribe, of obstructing justice by instructing his DNI not to release the whistleblower complaint. Those things are still illegal, regardless of whatever excuse he poses to try and justify it. It's pretty rich, by the way, that Trump would die on this hill of rooting out corruption when standing right behind him is his new UN ambassador Kelly Craft, who has zero qualifications but did donate $2 million to the Trump campaign. Wilbur Ross, Trump's commerce secretary, who didn't divest from major financial conflicts of interest despite promising he would. Steve Mnuchin, who, along with his wife, tried to use a $25,000 an hour government jet for his honeymoon. And then, of course, Trump himself, who, you know. So if he was that intent on rooting out corruption, he could probably start with this crew right here. The fact is that because not a single Republican has enough of a spine to cross Trump, even while he's systematically dismantling every tenet of our democracy, it's up to Democrats to hold him accountable. Because if they don't, it'll send a message to the entire world that all you have to do is start investigating Democrats to curry favor with the president, to start collecting $140 million bribes. We are at a historic juncture right now, and what happens next will determine whether the US remains committed to the rule of law or devolves into some banana republic in service of Donald Trump.